Welcome to H. Gerstner & Sons video on how to recover a Gerstner front lid using Gerstner leatherette. Walter Rickard, one of Gerstner's veteran employees, will demonstrate how you can glue the leatherette to the front lid of a chest. The glue we are using for this demonstration is Gerstner Woo Glue. Gerstner Woo Glue is the same animal hide glue that we use in our factory. We have packaged the animal hide glue with some other essential supplies into a kit called Gerstner Woo Glue that you can use at home. You can see that there is a line on the piece of leatherette for the front lid. The line indicates the position that the front lid should be placed at once the glue has been applied to the front lid. The line will make it easier to be sure the front lid is centered on the leatherette. To create the front lid position line, you should place the front lid on the leatherette, then measure from the edge of the leatherette to each side of the front lid. Once you have the front lid centered on the leatherette, draw a line, including the corner marks, to indicate where to place the lid after applying the glue. There is an inside and an outside to the front lid. The inside of the front lid has a recessed center panel, while the outside of the front lid will be an even surface. We will start by applying the first coat of glue to the outside of the front lid. Start applying the glue directly to the front lid. As you brush on the glue, it should be a thin, even coat of glue. If there are lumps in your glue, you need to check the water temperature to make sure it is hot enough. If the temperature is correct and you are still getting lumps, you may need to add some water to the glue to thin it out more. Keep applying glue until the entire face of the front lid is covered. If you apply too much glue or take too long, the glue can cool and become lumpy as you brush it on. When you are finished applying the glue to the front lid, turn the lid over and place the lid at the line that you created on the leatherette to center the lid. With the lid in the proper position, turn the lid over and use the palm of your hand to smooth the leatherette. Start from the center of the lid and work your way out, trying to push out any air bubbles that you can feel under the leatherette. If you feel any hard bumps under the leatherette, peel the leatherette back and remove the debris, then continue smoothing until the leatherette is flat on the panel. If the leatherette isn't staying down on the panel, and the glue feels slippery, not sticky, you may have too much water mixed with the glue. If you have too much water mixed with the glue, let the glue on the panel sit for a few minutes. Once you feel the glue starting to tack, continue smoothing the leatherette. If you have any glue that has been dripped or smeared onto the leatherette, you can use a rag with warm water to clean it up. After the leatherette is smooth and flat, turn the lid back over. To prevent the leatherette from overlapping, we will cut the corners of the leatherette even with the edges of the lid. This will also allow you to fold each side of the leatherette one at a time. You can draw a line with a straight edge as a guide for cutting the leatherette if you need it. Once the corners are cut out, you will apply glue to the edge of the front lid. You can also brush some glue onto the leatherette to create an even coat of glue. You can apply the glue to all edges of the front lid at this time, or just the edge that you want to work with first. Next, you will apply glue to the frame of the front lid. You can apply the glue to the side that you are going to work with first, or the entire lid. Make sure you get glue onto the edge of the lip of the center panel. You will also need glue about 1 inch into the center panel area. Start with the flap on one side of the front lid. Push down against the center of the front lid while you pull up the leatherette against the edge of the lid. Use your fingers to create a crease at the top edge of the front lid while pushing against the side of the lid with your fingers to work out any air pockets. Smooth the leatherette with the palm of your hand and fingers from the side toward the center panel. Make sure you have the leatherette tight against the side of the lid and continue to smooth the leatherette on the face of the lid. You can add some glue to the leatherette where the top and bottom flaps will overlap the side you just completed, or you can wait until you have completed the opposite side of the lid before adding any glue. Now repeat the same steps as before. Push down against the center of the front lid while you pull up the leatherette against the edge of the lid. Use your fingers to create a crease at the top edge of the front lid while pushing against the side of the lid with your fingers to work out any air pockets. Smooth the leatherette with the palm of your hand and fingers from the side towards the center panel. Next, you will cut the leatherette where it overhangs the center panel. Cut the leatherette at the edge of the center panel to the corner of the center panel. This will allow you to work the leatherette against the lip of the center panel. Add some glue to the leatherette where the top and bottom sides will overlap the flap you just completed. Next, you will cut the leatherette where it overhangs the center panel on the opposite side. Repeat the process with the long flaps at the top and bottom of the front lid. Now that you have finished all four sides, check the edges of the front lid to make sure that the leatherette is flat and there aren't any air pockets under the leatherette. The next step is to make a diagonal cut from the corner of the center panel to the outside corner of the front lid. Your goal is to cut through both pieces of leatherette when you make the diagonal cut. Remove the top piece of leatherette that you have cut off and set it aside. Next, peel back the long flap of leatherette to expose the cut corner of the side piece of leatherette. Since the side piece of leatherette has been glued down for a little bit, you can use the utility knife to get under the edge of the leatherette to pull it up. Once the cut side piece is removed, smooth the leatherette down against the lid. You can add some more glue if necessary. Repeat the process for the other three corners of the lid. Use a rag with warm water to wipe off any excess glue on the leatherette. Now it is time for the final smoothing of the leatherette. Add glue to any areas that are not sticking well and smooth out any remaining air pockets. That concludes our video on how to recover a Gerstner front lid using Gerstner leatherette. Thank you for watching.